Good afternoon, everyone. I am Advika. This is English Literature for ICC Syllabus Chapter 2, Ivan's Story by the book Gulmohar, written by Catherine Applegate. Ivan family, Ivan Silverback. The image of Ivan, the Silverback, and Ivan family. Ivan is a gorilla who lives in a cage at a mall. He has spent 27 years either living in the human home or at the mall. The story is told by Ivan is about how he had nearly forgotten his life in the wild. The Grant. I was born in a place called Central Africa in a dense rainforest. So beautiful, no crayons could ever do it justice. Gorillas do not name their newborns right away. The humans do. We get to know our babies first. We wait to see hints of what might yet be. When they saw how much he loved to chase me around the forest, my parents decide on my twin sister's name, Tag. Oh, how I loved to play tag with my sister. She was nimble, but when I got too close, she would leap on my unsuspecting father. Then I would join her and we would bounce on his belly until he gave us a grunt, a sound that would mean enough. The game never got old, although father would get disagreed. Mud. It did not take long for my parents to find my name. All day long, every day, I made pictures. I drew on rocks and bugs and my poor mother's back. I used sap from the leaves. I used the juice from fruit. But mostly I used mud. And that is what they call me, mud. To a human, mud might not sound like much, but to me, it was everything. Protector. My family, which was called a troop, was just like another gorilla family. There were 10 of us. My father, the silverback, my mother, and 3 other adult females, a young male called Blackback, and 2 other young gorillas, Tag and I, were the babies of the group. We fought time to time, but my father knew how to control us with a simple scowl. And for the most part, we were happy to do what we were meant to do, to feed and search for food and nap and play. My father was a master at leading us to the ripest fruit for our morning feast and the finest branches for our night nest. He was everything a silver black is meant to be, a guide, a protector, or a teacher. The perfect life. Gorilla babies, elephant babies, and human babies are not so different, except the gorillas get to spend the day riding on his mother's back. Slowly, carefully, a young gorilla begins to go further and further away from the safety of his mother's arm. He learns the skill he will need as an adult. How to make nest of branches, weave them tightly or they will fall apart in the night. How to beat your chest, cup your palms to amplify the sound. How to move from tree to tree, don't let go. How to find kind, strong and loyal. As a young gorilla, you make mistakes, but you play, you learn, you do it over again. Then, one day, a still day when the hot air humed, the humans came, whined. After they captured my sister and me, they put us in a cramped, dark crate. Somehow I knew that in order to leave, I had to let off my old life die. But my sister could not let go of it. She kept thinking about our home all the time till she fell very sick. A temporary human. It was Mac who opened the crate, Mac who took me, and Mac who raised me like a human baby. I drank from a bottle, I slept on human bed, sat on human chairs, listened while human words swarmed around me like angry bees. Mac's wife, Helen, was quick to laugh but quick to anger too, especially when I broke something, which was often. I broke the blender when I squeezed 3 tubes of toothpaste and a bottle of glue into it. I broke my tooth attempting to from lamp fixture on the ceiling. I broke 46 glasses. Well, it turns out there are many ways to break a glass. Every weekend, Mac and Helen drove me to a restaurant where they ordered something for me. I went to baseball games, the grocery store, and the movie theater, even to the circus. They did not have a gorilla. I rode on a little motorbike and blew candles on my birthday cake. My life as a human, I was well taken care of, an exciting one, although my not proved. Hunger. In my new life as a human, I was well taken care of. Yet at night, lying on my pyjamas, I longed for the cheerful grunts of a play fight and the easy safety of my nearby troop. Remember what happened to Tag? I told myself, don't think about the jungle. Till something, I lay awake wishing for the warmth of another just like me. Later, Ivan is sent to a shop mall. He becomes a part of stationary circus for many, many years. Here, he becomes used to humans watching him all the time, and he hardly thinks of the jungle. After people began to protest about Ivan's living condition at the mall, he is adopted by a zoo. To know more about what happened to Ivan, read the complete novel, Adapted by The One and Only Ivan by Catherine Applegate. Meanings: grunt, a short, low sound. Nimble, able to move easily and quickly. Scowl, an angry look. Amplify, make louder. Cramped, small and crowded with not much space to move. Crate, a large wooden container for transporting something. Swan, crowded. Approved, thought of something as good. Stationary, nothing to move, not being to be moved. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to our channel.